Ecotourism has been described as a responsible form of travel, one which aims at preserving the environment while minimizing the negative impact travelers often leave behind. This trend is not new in the south of Israel, where visitors are offered sites which combine a green approach with a wonderful vacation. Let's head to the Arava, where the desert reveals its exotic magic. We begin our journey on an enchanted hilltop eco-village called Desert Days, where the wilderness can be experienced in all its golden glory. It was founded by Yair and Rinat, a couple of city slickers who gave up urban life to create their desert dream.
We decided basically to go in something that we believe in and something that combine we work hard, very hard, a lot of hours, but we are with our family. My children are with me, I'm with my children. We live together, we work together, we do together things. I know them, they know me.
Yair and Rinat are creating a truly ecological experience, having designed the entire village to blend into the rugged terrain. They're building it all by hand, hut by hut, using only the most natural of materials, mud and straw bales, along with recycled bottles. The materials are not only eco-friendly, they also insulate far better than your average cement blocks. Cooling and heating of the huts is powered by solar panels, which also provide electricity for the entire village. The retreat is geared primarily for family activities, from lessons in mud hut construction to making ceramics out of donkey waste to exploring the rich treasures of the desert. This bowl is full of fossilized shark's teeth found in this area, which was many thousands of years ago, believe it or not, a massive lake. Our next eco stop takes us several kilometers down the road.
If you're looking for a real, authentic desert experience, then this is the place. It's called the Spice Root Inn. Why is it called the Spice Root Inn? Well, 2,000 years ago, an ancient nomadic tribe called the Nabataeans used to transport spices all the way from the Far East through Yemen down south, up through the desert, past this very spot where we're standing right now, to Gaza, where it was all shipped off to Europe. And the Spice Root Inn tries to replicate that ancient experience from 2,000 years ago. One of the cool things about the Spice Root Inn is the guests stay in accommodations which are closest to what the residents of the desert, the Bedouins, stay in, which are these tents. One interesting thing to note about these tents is that they all face east. Now, why is that? Well, as we all know, the desert gets really hot during the day and very, very cold during the night. So the fact that it's closed on the west side prevents the cold wind from blowing in at night and cooling off the tent even more. It's open in the east, so as soon as the sun rises, the sun rays come in and warm up the tent during the day. And then the west side can be opened to allow the cool desert breeze in and cool off the place even more.
That's just one of the ways the family-run inn lets guests experience authentic desert hospitality along with traditional Bedouin-style living, much like the biblical Abraham did when he welcomed guests into his desert tent.
The first thing he does is welcoming them, and he's saying his wife to make a cake, to make bread, and he's saying someone else to go and get the best goat, put them on the fire. He's giving a full attention of the guest. Okay, this is, I think, what have to be in every hospitality during the desert.
Guests are invited to adventure along the age-old perfume roads on the ship of the desert, in this case, a lovely dromedary named Luna. After a great sleep in the cool desert air, we begin our next day at a unique cafe called the Vegetable Garden, situated inside a greenhouse on Moshav Tzofar. The food is made out of organic produce picked just centimeters from the table. It doesn't get any fresher than this. Just half a kilometer down the road is an oasis of Israeli ecotourism, Kibbutz Lotan. The entire kibbutz is dedicated to creating a greener way of life and to spreading the word. The kibbutz teaches students from all over the world how to make their lives more eco-friendly.
So they learn simple things, how to save water in their homes, what food is really in season where they live. They learn how people can interact with each other in a less violent way. They learn a lot of little things that I think can enhance their lives, but mostly it's confidence, I think, that these things are possible.
Very interested in ecology and natural building and living in Israel.
I also am really interested in Judaism, and I wanted to spend some time in a Jewish community. And some places I looked into, well, I'm not Jewish, so I couldn't do that. But here I could, so.
How's your experience been?
It's been really great.
And this is Captain Compost. He's the mascot slash superhero of the kibbutz. He's here to welcome us to a very special attraction called Eco Fun, which combines fun with ecological awareness for the entire family. Because everything you see in this playground is made from old junk, trash, bottles, tires, you name it, they've recycled it and turned it into these toys for kids to play with, including this old VW love bug.
Lotan has plenty to offer weekend tourists as well, such as a shiatsu massage in the water called Watsu, where the healing powers of the water and the desert come together. Another great attraction is this natural bird sanctuary, built to give the millions of birds migrating through Israel a place to rest their wings and replenish themselves. Bird lovers from all over the world come to catch a glimpse of rare species like the red-breasted flycatcher, the little green bee eaters, the rufous bush robin, and dozens more.
For migrants that go through here by the millions every year, this is a real migrant magnet, providing water, shelter, and the most important things that birds need in migration. This is not a zoo. This is first and foremost for the birds. And we get our peace of mind from, you know, from watching it.
And with that look at our fine feathered friends, we'll say goodbye to our marvelous desert surroundings, hoping that we left behind the smallest footprint possible.